Hi there, this video will go over how to download, edit and save Twinkl's interactive PDFs. Our engaging interactive PDF resources are designed to help all involved in teaching by taking the learner beyond the basic on-screen reading experience, giving them more and enhancing their experience. This video guide will help you and those using the resources get the most out of them. The idea is that students can complete Twinkl activities digitally without the need for a printer and to make learning at home easier. Here you can see a classic Twinkl activity where normally you would need to print to then fill in the boxes, take a picture of the finished sheet and send back to teachers. Whereas now you can download these interactive PDFs to save all the hassle. I'm going to show you how to do this on a variety of platforms, starting with on your phones, then on an iPad and finally showing you on a Windows PC and a Mac laptop. So on an Android phone, on the Twinkl website, if you download as normal, then you should be given the option to open as a PDF. Whichever is your default PDF viewer, for me it was the OneDrive PDF. And first thing to do is save in your documents and upload to the OneDrive. Once that's done, it's a good idea to come out of your apps and go to your OneDrive and open the PDF directly from there. On Android phones, you can click in the text boxes to type or use the annotate button to choose a pen, and a child can annotate on the screen and write as they wish. Once finished, stop annotating and click the share button to then click save. If the activity is complete, you can then share via email or do this at a later date. On an iPad, follow the usual routine of clicking download or alternative versions. It automatically brings up the resource, then click the share button and click save to files. You can change the name of the document so it's easier to find and save it in your chosen folder. Now close the web browser and open the PDF from your files to start working on it. You can type the answers into the text boxes and continue to tap on each box to type in the answers. This is on an iPad with an external keyboard. If you have an iPad without a keyboard, the keyboard will pop up on the screen and you can type in this way. However, just like on the Android, you can also annotate and erase using the pen feature. To save the edited version, click share and save to files again. This time change the title so that you don't save over the original. You can now see the edited version next to the original in your files. To send the document on, open the PDF, click share and decide how to share, for example via email. And as if by magic, this works in a similar way on iPhones as well. Next, on a computer, let's start with a Windows PC. Download and open with your default PDF viewer. For me, it's Microsoft Edge. Save to your document straight away and close your browser to then open it directly from files to ensure it's the right one. Then you can start editing. Again, you can type directly into the text boxes by clicking on them and typing, or you can click the draw button and annotate like this, which your child may find helpful. Finally, you could save or save as with a new name such as complete or finished. And again, you should see it in your documents and be able to open the edited version, which then you can send on. There are also PDFs available, which include drop-down combo boxes, which are great for multiple choice questions, and text boxes, which are multi-line and scrollable. Alternatively, you can open the PDF in Adobe Acrobat Reader, where you can use the post-it notes to add comments. For example, if you helped your child with a question, you could leave a post-it note for the teacher to see on the specific question you helped with. You can also use the highlighter to highlight key parts of questions to support your child. You can type in the boxes just like you could on Microsoft Edge. And if you go to Tools and then click Comment, the Comment toolbar will come up showing you lots of features, including the pen where you can choose a color to draw or write directly onto the PDF. And of course, this can be erased as well. Just like I said before, don't forget to save as and open the document up again to check that your answers are there before you send this on. On a Mac laptop, as always, click download or choose from the alternative versions. So I've chosen a middle ability version. It will either prompt a pop-up to save to your device or it will download in your browser. If it's the first option, then go to the location it's been saved in. If it's in the downloads in your browser, then you can click the download button and save the PDF to your chosen location. Then go to your downloads folder or chosen location and open the PDF from there. Again, as on the other platforms, you can type directly into the text boxes or annotate with a pen or highlighter. You can use a drop-down combo box to select an answer and type in the boxes. And like before, you can save as with a different file name and send on or share. A final warning for you, some activities and PDFs come with the answers in the same document or same file as the questions, so be careful not to send children the answers as well, although I'm sure they'd love it. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video has helped with using Twinkl's interactive PDFs. See you soon!